many traders have often faced the situation where their trades hit stop loss due to false breakouts. This not only affects the trading process, but also causes stress and fear, making traders hesitant to place orders in the future. Let's take a look at the following scenario to decide whether we should place a buy or sell order. In this case, some traders will enter a buy order when they see breakouts like that. However, these breakouts often contain false breakouts that trick investors into entering a trade, which then leads to them getting stop loss. However, using fake breakouts is how we trade with the Storm Eye indicator. With the Storm Eye indicator, it helps you avoid trading on a false breakout and makes your entries more reliable. Let's take a look at its performance overview. Let's dive into our newly launched indicator called Storm Eye. First, let's begin with why it's called Storm Eye. We named it Storm Eye for this reason. Low volatility represents calm before a storm. The initial breakout signals the storm's onset. Afterward, calm returns following the initial storm appearance. Many may mistake the storm has passed, unaware they are in the eye. As the eye passes, the outer storm forms with even greater strength than at the storm's beginning. This illustrates the breakaway candlestick, denouncing the previous false breakout candle. The entry signals of the Storm Eye is identified through the following steps. First, identify a breakout after a period of low price volatility. Then, identify a reverse breakaway against the initial breakout to confirm it's a false breakout. Next, look for confirmation that this reverse break is reliable. Finally, generate an entry signal. First, let's look at how the indicator identifies a breakout. We define a breakout not just as a movement through a horizontal price range or the break of a support arch resistance level. Our definition is more specific. A breakout candle is the one with the largest body compared to the candles before it, and it occurs at the end of a low volatility cycle. We call this breakout candle the first bar. In the following example, the search cycle for the first bar is 10. This means the first bar is the candle at the end of the cycle and must have a larger body than the 9 previous candles. The first bar will be marked with a yellow dot. A note on adjusting the first bar period parameter is that increasing this value will result in fewer signals, while decreasing it will generate more signals. Let's talk a bit about the low volatility price range needed to find the first bar. We define a low volatility price range not just as a sideways market. It can also include periods where the candles are not moving up or down too strongly and have low momentum. After the appearance of the first bar, marked with a yellow dot, the market does not follow the direction of this candle, but instead creates a strong reverse breakaway. This reverse breakaway is represented by a candle with a larger body than the first bar, marked with a star symbol and referred to as the second bar. In the settings, we define the criteria for identifying the second bar. For instance, the second bar search period is set to 5 candles. If, within this period following the breakout of the first bar, no candle appears with a larger body moving counter to the first bar's direction, the indicator confirms that no breakaway has occurred. You can see the first bar candle is red with a 4-tick body, and the second bar candle is green with a 5-tick body. This second bar candle meets the conditions to form. Note that when adjusting the second bar period parameter, increasing this value will result in more signals being formed, while decreasing it will result in fewer signals. Next, let's proceed to the steps for confirming signals. After the price creates a reverse breakaway with the second bar, negating the initial breakout of the first bar, the indicator will seek confirmation to validate the reliability of this reverse breakaway. Looking at the following example, the signal search area is set to 2 in the settings. This means both candles following the second bar must satisfy the conditions defined in the parameters: signal bar, max body, and max retracement. You should avoid setting too many candles for signal bar period, as it can delay signals and lead to missed trading opportunities. We highly recommend setting this parameter between 2 and 3 for increased trading opportunities. Let's explore the signal bar, max body, and max retracement parameters to understand how the indicator defines entry signals. The signal bar, max body, percent parameter specifies the maximum length of candle bodies within the signal search range, measured as a percentage, compared to the body length of the second bar. This means that within the signal search range, the candle bodies must not exceed 100% of the second bar's body length. In this illustration, you can see that neither of the two candles within the signal search range have bodies larger than the second bars. Therefore, this signal is valid. Next, with the max retracement parameter, we have two modes, percent and tick. Max retracement in percent mode determines the maximum retracement level of closing prices, measured as a percentage, for the candles considered in the signal search compared to the second bar. In the following example, with a signal search range of two candles, neither candle retraces with a closing price exceeding 50% of the second bar. Next, we will talk about max retracement in tick mode. In this mode, all settings remain unchanged, except that max retracement is calculated in ticks instead of percentages. The indicator will determine the maximum retracement level in ticks. In the example, we can see that the maximum retracement level is set at 20 ticks. Both candles within the signal search range have closing prices that do not exceed the specified tick count. The first candle retraces only 14 ticks, and the second candle retraces only 5 ticks. Therefore, this signal is valid. I have completed the comprehensive introduction to the signal mechanism of the StormEye. Next up, we have an exciting part, demo trading with StormEye. Firstly, I'll initiate a long position with two contracts. I'll position the stop just below the second bar candle and set the reward to risk ratios at 2-1 and 3-1 for the two contracts, respectively. This strategy is rooted in the second bar's role. It signifies the rejection of the preceding sell candle, indicating robust buying pressure. If there's a reversal with selling pressure surpassing the second bar candle, it signals heightened selling momentum, potentially driving the price lower again. Hence, placing the stop near the second bar helps manage risks effectively. We'll apply the same approach in a sell scenario, setting the stop above the second bar and establishing a 3.1 reward to risk ratio. We hope that the StormEye indicator will assist you in navigating false breakouts and trading with increased confidence. Wishing you all successful trading days ahead. Remember to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to stay updated with our newest videos.